Bonjour mes chers élèves de la classe 8 et 9. I'm recording two lessons for you now because our last two lessons didn't really work. The first one was when I only talked to the grade 9s. I didn't know that the two groups weren't joined, so the grade 8s didn't have a lesson. And then the second one was load shedding. So I prepared everything, but then I had a problem. But before I had a problem, most of you left the meeting because you also had load shedding. So I think maybe you also missed that lesson. So I will meet with you on Wednesday and next Wednesday before the holidays. I'll schedule a meeting, but I'll now split the two groups. I'll try to do the grade 9s from the grade 8s from 4 to 4:30, and then the grade 9s from 4:30 to 5. So just to recap and do everything and all the revision and so on. You only have to do up to lesson 3 in grade 8 and 9. So don't worry about being behind. But I'm doing the lessons. I don't know if you found the recording. If you did, it's fine. If you didn't, I'm going to do the rest of lesson 3 and the revision lesson with you in the next two lessons. So I'll send you the links. Then I know that maybe this week it's load shedding again and you have problems and we don't know how to do. And I sincerely hope that at the end, after the holidays, we'll be back together in class. I hope so, because it's very difficult to teach you a language and I don't really see you. But let's make the best of it. I am in your tricolore book now, à la page 22. The last lesson that we had on Teams, the one that I think that worked, you had to do numéro 2 et 3, I think, or you had to, yeah, 2 et 3, you had to fill in the avoir and the être à la page 22. Then I know, Amrusha, some of you have the new book, and the new book, it's à la page 24. So I'll try to always tell you on the new, in the new book, on which page. The most of the exercises are completely the same. It's just pages that differ. So remember, the lesson is now, or you have now to know, how do you say I am and how do you say I have? So those were two verbs, avoir and être. Avoir is to have and être is to be. And I explained to you that those are irregular verbs. You have to learn them off by heart. And at the back of the book, you find it. But it's also in the beginning of your book, in the lessons, but it's not all together. Sometimes they only give you the single and then the plural. So let's do être. Let's say I am. That was je suis. You are, tu es. He is, il est, and she is, elle est. And one is, they use one a lot in French, on est. We are, nous sommes. You are, vous êtes, they are, ils sont, and feminine they, elles sont. It's very important that you learn it off by heart, that you write it out 20, 50 times till you get it. Then avoir, to have. Can you remember? Avoir was the infinitive. That's the name of the verb. That's like the surname of a family, but everybody's got his own name. So I have is j'ai, you have, tu as, he has, il a, and she has, elle a. And one has, on a. It's the same, il and elle and on are usually the same. We have, nous avons. You have, vous avez. They have, ils ont, and elles ont. So that's on. That's why I say zon. That's elle ends on an S and then on. But they are with elles sont. And you have to fill it in, exercise 2 et 3. So I'm reading now the answers to Karine. Karine says, that's an email, a mail. So she says, salut, je suis ta correspondante française. Je m'appelle Karine. J'ai un frère Benjamin, il est amusante. J'ai aussi une demi-sœur Clara, Elle est fantastique. Et toi, do you have sisters and brothers? As-tu des frères et sœurs? Are you? Es-tu? Yes. Es-tu sportif comme moi? Please answer me quickly. Réponds vite, Karine. Bon. Then numéro 3. Now you have to fill in your own. So you have to change now if it's feminine or masculine, or if you want to say something. So the verb is going to be the same, but maybe your answer is not the same than mine. So you're going to say, salut, je suis. So if you are a boy correspondent, you say, je suis ton correspondant. If you are a girl, je suis ta, and then correspondante got an E. Je suis ta correspondante, et je m'appelle Paul, Clara, Naomi, whoever you are. Now you can say, I am an only child, or I'm not an only child, or an only boy, a son, or an only girl, daughter. So you say, je suis fils unique. That means I am an only boy, only son. Or you say, je ne suis pas fils unique. I'm not the only boy or the only son. Or you can say, je suis fille unique. I'm the only daughter, the only girl. Or I'm not, je ne suis pas fille unique. It depends on who you are. Then, je suis très sportif. That's for a boy. I'm very sporty. Or je ne suis pas très sportif. I'm not very sporty. And then your sportif ends on an F. Or if you're a girl, you use the feminine form of sportive with a VE. So you say, je suis très sportive if you do a lot of sport. Or if you're not very sporty, you say, je ne suis pas très sportive. Ça va? I have a friend, a boy friend, not a boyfriend, boyfriend, a masculine friend. J'ai un ami without the E. If I have a girl, a feminine friend, j'ai une amie with an E. If it was a boy, you said, il s'appelle Paul. If it was a girl, elle s'appelle Amélie. Il est amusant with a no E, and then he is very interesting, amusing. Or if it's a she, elle est amusante with an E. And then please answer quickly, réponds vite, Paul. Voilà. So please make sure that you understand everything on this page. That was the first part of the lesson, was about the family. Can you remember le frère, et ma soeur, et mon père, et ma mère? So you described your family. The second part is now about the house. So let's just go à la page, to your vocabulaire, à la page 27. Et Amrusha, for you, it's à la page 29. À la page 27, we did that already, but just look at talk about my home. In the first column at the bottom, talk about my home. Let's go through that again, because we're going to do the exercises on that now. In my house, there is or there are. Dans ma maison, il y a. Dans ma maison, il y a. And these are the different rooms. La salle à manger, le salon, la cuisine, la salle de bain, la chambre, les toilettes, le garage, le jardin. And then they have a bed, un lit. Voilà. Now you can go back, s'il vous plaît, à la page 23, and for the other book, Amrusha, page 25. Now we're going to put the persons in the home. Voilà. So numéro 4 says, la maison de la famille Laurent. Now remember how we say possession, we don't say the Laurent's family's house. You must turn it around and say the house of the famille Laurent. Now let's see if you can match the rooms and the numbers. So you must tell me if I say le salon, you can tell me it's numéro J. Ça va? Le salon, I tell you it's numéro J. So that's a sitting room. La salle à manger, where do you find la salle à manger? J. Okay? Dining room. La cuisine, look if you can find la cuisine. H. Les toilettes. So there's a toilet with E and a toilet on top, but that's actually the bathroom. I think it's the top floor. It's numéro D. Then Monsieur and Madame Laurent's room. So the French say the room of Monsieur and Madame Laurent. So they say la chambre de Monsieur et Madame Laurent. So where do you think is that? Ah. Oui, ah. La chambre de Thomas et Daniel, the two boys. La chambre, so Thomas and Daniel's room, that will be numéro C. La chambre de Louise, B. La salle de bain, that's now the bathroom, the whole complete bathroom, c'est numéro D. Et le jardin, the garden, pardon. E, that's the garden. Et le garage, c'est numéro F. Now, when we're done with the lesson, just see and walk around your house and see if you can remember all the rooms. Remember, you must speak it. You must repeat it. You must practice it. Otherwise, you forget it. Bon. Now, we have a letter of Louise Laurent, and she writes about her house. And then we have to match our sentences. Bon. So I'm going to read it slowly. Try to read and understand with me. Bon. Je suis Louise Laurent. Voici notre maison et notre jardin. Now remember, notre is our. And here is voici le garage. Dans la maison, il y a 8 pièces, 8 rooms. Le salon, la salle à manger, la cuisine, les toilettes, la salle de bain et 3 chambres. Dans la chambre de mes parents, my parents' room, dans la chambre de mes parents, il y a un lit et un lecteur CD. Dans la chambre de Thomas et Daniel, il y a 2 lits, une console de jeu et toutes les affaires de mes yeux. Console de jeu is like a game station. Il y a une télévision dans le salon et aussi dans la chambre de mes parents et de mes frères. Il y a aussi un téléphone dans la chambre de maman et de papa. Dans la salle à manger, il y a une table et 5 chaises. Dans la cuisine, il y a une radio et un téléphone. So remember, the telephone is now is more than one telephone. Dans la chambre, dans ma chambre, in my room, il y a mon lecteur CD, mon ordinateur et regardez sur mon lit. Il y a mon chat Mimi. Can you see there's a cat on her bed? Sur is on. Now, numéro 5, that's on page 23 et 25 in the other book. You now have to match the sentences so that it makes sense. In other words, if I say dans la maison, you will have, look for number B, 8 pièces. Il y a 8 pièces. Il y a un téléphone. Now, where did you find the telephone? In all which rooms? Dans la chambre de Monsieur et Madame Laurent et dans la cuisine. So that will be your homework. So please write it down. In the team's lesson, the half an hour lesson that we then have, I will mark this. Ça va? Then numéro 5 à la page 23 and the other book page 25. Bon. So, s'il vous plaît, tournez la page et regardez page 24. Now, on this page, in this part, you're going to learn to about the furniture, about the things in the room and where it is, and say on top and underneath. And so let's see. Notre chambre. On top of the page, you have c'est où? It's where? C'est où? It is where? C'est où? Now the boys are describing their room. Now, if you look at leur chambre, you can say that once you can see that one side of the room is very neat and the other side is en désordre. Okay, so let's read. Je suis Thomas Laurent et Daniel est mon petit frère. Et voici notre chambre et notre console avec les jeux vidéo et les manettes. What do you call it that you use to do all the things on your game station? The controls. Les manettes. Voici mes affaires. Can you see the mes now plural? Because affaires is plural. Voici mes affaires, my things. If you talk about your things in general, you just talk about mes affaires. Mes livres sont sur la table et mes crayons sont dans la boîte. Now, they want to teach you now here in the book to say dans, that's inside. Sur, that's on top, and sous, that's underneath. So, dans, sur, sous. Mon stylo est sur le cahier, on the book, et mes classeurs sont sous la table, underneath the table. Et voilà mon baladeur. My iPod, what I listen to in my... Et voilà mon baladeur. So, that is Thomas. Now, which one do you think Thomas is, the neat one? Or the désordre one, the one that's en ordre, that's very neat. Now Daniel is talking. Et voici les affaires de mon frère Daniel. He's talking about Daniel now, but that's chaos. Où est le sac à dos? Ah oui, il est sur le lit, on the bed. Dans le sac, il y a une règle et des livres. Et qu'est-ce qu'il y a sous le lit? Underneath the bed. Voilà, le baladeur de Daniel est sous le lit. Et voici la trousse, the pencil bag de Daniel. Il est sur la chaise. And what is in the trousse? Qu'est-ce qu'il y a dans la trousse? Regardez. Il y a une gomme dans la trousse, mais les crayons et les stylos sont sous la chaise. Voilà, c'est très, très, très en désordre. Bon, so now look at your room and see où est mon stylo, où est mon livre, where are all these things. Now, numéro 2, we have now to fill in. Now, look, they give you the prepositions there, sur, on top. Dans, inside, and sous, underneath. Now they want us to fill it in. So let's see. Please just pause the video if I give the answer too quick, but try to put it in yourself. La télévision est la chambre. Dans, inside. Où est le sac à dos? Where is the backpack? Il est sur le lit de Daniel. Où est la gomme de Daniel? Elle est, where is the gomme? Dans la trousse. Et la trousse, where is the trousse? Où est la trousse? Sur la chaise. Les crayons de Thomas sont, now can you see that the verb now became plural? It was et, la trousse et is, but the crayons are, so they become sont. So, les crayons de Thomas sont, oh, they're all underneath the chair, so it's sous la chaise. Les crayons de Thomas sont sous la boîte et la boîte est, oh, sorry, it's Thomas, pardon, c'est Thomas. Les crayons de Thomas sont dans la boîte et la boîte est sur la table. I'm looking at the other one. La règle de Daniel, where is his ruler? La règle de Daniel est dans le sac. Où est le baladeur? Where is his iPod de Daniel? Il est sous le lit. Et où est le baladeur de Thomas? Il est sur, sous, where is it? Where is the baladeur de Thomas? Sur la chaise. So that's the big one. So, sur, sous, and dans. Underneath that you have a little story about Suzanne and Suzette Souris. That's just for pronunciation. So just try to say it with me. The U. I know that some people really have difficulty in pronouncing the U. Suzanne and Suzette. Bon. So let's read number one. Suzanne Souris est sur la boîte. La boîte est sur la table. So Suzanne Souris is on the box and the box is on the table. Say that again. Suzanne Souris est sur la boîte. La boîte est sur la table. Now the second one. Look at her sister Suzette Souris. Suzette is very, very amusing. Funny. Voici sa sœur Suzette Souris. Suzette est amusante. Yeah, let's say it again. Voici sa sœur Suzette Souris. Suzette est amusante. And the last one. La boîte est sous la table. Suzanne et Suzette Souris sont aussi sous la table. So the box is on the table. And Suzanne and Suzette are all underneath the table, and Suzanne and Souris are all also underneath the table. Let's read it again. So if you have difficulty, remember U, 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 U. So la boîte est sous la table. Suzanne et Suzette Souris sont aussi sous la table. Sous la table. Voilà. Page 25. And for you, Amrusha, and your others, maybe that have this book, c'est à la page 27. Now, remember that your dossier langue is when you have to learn, that's the rules. That's telling you what is the grammar, what are the grammar rules. So, now we have already talked about this in class, masculine and feminine. I'll read what the book says. All nouns in French are either masculine or feminine. You can often tell if a word is masculine or feminine because of the word which goes in front of it. In other words, if you have a mon, you know it's a masculine word because mon is what you use for possession, for masculine, and un. And if you have feminine, so mon frère a un chat, it's both masculine. But feminine, voici la radio de ta sœur. So, la is for feminine, and ta sœur is also for feminine. So, everything sort of goes together. Everything is in harmony in French. So, let's look at the tableau. They ask us to complete le tableau, to now to fill in the tableau. So, they've got a masculine and then feminine. And then remember when a word starts with a vowel, the le and the la. The E disappears. So now they say, what is a before a masculine word? Un. And before a feminine word? Une. So, and with a word beginning with a vowel, it stays un or in. The, before a masculine word will be le. And they give you, before a feminine word is la. And then in front of a word, before a word starting with a vowel, the le or the la disappears, the e or the a, and it's l apostrophe. The apostrophe tells you that you left out something. My before a masculine word is mon. Before a feminine word, can you remember? Ma. And before a word beginning with a vowel, I can't use ma. Can you remember? It's always mon. It stays mon because otherwise you can't pronounce it. And then your before a masculine word is ton. Before a feminine word is ta. And then before a word starts with a vowel, it stays the masculine one, ton. Très bien. Now remember, if I want to say, just look at the right-hand side. The French for he is il, so all masculine words take the verb of il, and all feminine word takes the verb of elle. But they mean il and elle can also mean it. So even if the table, they talk about the table and she's feminine, she talk about elle. We say it, but the French say she is brown. If I talk about maybe the ceiling, they talk about le plafond. So they will say, he is white. We will say, it is white. So all masculine words are ill and all feminine words are out, even if they're not persons. So look at the table there. There's a crayon sur la table. And there's a trousse sous la table. And then it's full of crayon, I think, dans la trousse. So now look at the English sentences. Where is the pencil? Où est le crayon? Now try to answer without looking at the French. He is on the table because the pencil is now a he. Il est sur la table. And then, and here is the pencil case. And voici la trousse. And where is she? Elle est sous la table. We translate it in English with it, in Afrikaans with dit, but in French they say he and she, even if it's something that's not a human. That's something to get used to, I know. Ça va? Now, masculine and feminine, they actually tell us we must make two lists, like masculin, un livre, a book, feminin, une gomme, your rubber or something like that. But let's just look at the words at the right-hand side in that little block and tell me if it's feminine or masculine. Un livre is masculine. Ta gomme, féminin. Un crayon, masculin. Ma calculatrice, féminin. Ton ami. Now, ton must be because it's a word with a vowel, but ami doesn't have an e, so ami is masculine, so it's masculin. Un ordinateur, masculin. Le cartable, masculin. Ta chaise, féminin. Le baladeur, masculin. L'ami. Now, ami's got an E, so it's a feminine friend, but the la, the A is gone now because there's an apostrophe, because there's two vowels next to each other. So it's la ami. Mon grand-père, masculin, in une table, féminin. Bon. Maintenant, la dernière question à la page 25, the last exercise on page 25. Is we now have to find the trouver the family members of this the strange family of the the strange name. So où est numéro 4, number 4 means where is, où est. So you can see numéro 1, où est le chat? Numéro 2, où est Anferina? Numéro 3, où est l'ordinateur de Tombo? Where is Tombo's computer, ordi? Numéro 4, où est le château de la famille Corpuscule? Where are the Corpuscule family's château? Numéro 5, où est Draculine? That's the mother. Où est la souris? Where is the mouse? Où est le dragon of Anferina's dragon? And then the last one, où est désastreux baladeur? Now, if you look at the left-hand side, there's the answers. So I'll give you a few minutes. Just quickly match the answers with the right place. Remember, I'm going on, but you have to pause the video now because I'm going to give you the answers. In class, I will wait for you, but now I'm giving you the answers. So pause the video and hear that on. So, elle est sous la table, will be numéro 2, Anferina. Il est dans le jardin, will be numéro 4, le château. Now, Draculi is also in the garden, but she's feminine. But this is a masculine. They say he is in the garden, so that's Le Chateau. Il est sur la table. That's the cat. Numéro un. Il est sous le lit. That's numéro trois. That's l'ordinateur de tombeau. Elle est sur le lit. That's numéro six. That's the mouse on the bed. Numéro F, il est dans le dragon. That's the last one. Où est le baladeur de désastre? It's in his mouth. Numéro G, this feminine one. Elle est dans le jardin. That's Draculine. She's in the garden. And the numéro H, il est sur la chaise. He is on the chair. That is Enferina's dragon. Le dragon d'Enferina. Voilà. So that is just to practice your prepositions. Bon. Now, à la page 26. Now, the other book, Amrusha, you have another little thing there that you can just fill in. And then you have, à la page 28, you have another exercise about the family extraordinaire and Albin. You don't have this page that we have about the numbers, but just listen. If I see you again, I will just ask you or just help you, but that's just a revision of numbers, so just listen very well. Bon. Les nombres. So that's just to revise the numbers. We already have it. And then at the right-hand side of your page, you have stratégie. Remember, stratégie is always things that can help you, little clues or little tips. They say you have learned a lot of new words in this unit. Why not start writing your own vocabulary book, building it up with every unit? You can organize it in topics like ma famille, ma maison, ma chambre. Just remember one thing. If you write it, if you draw it, if you say it, if you repeat it, if you read it, you remember it more clearly. Bon, so that's your choice. Bon, will you look, s'il vous plaît, regardez numéro 1, c'est quel nombre? It is which number? So I'm going to read the numbers and you can tell me in English. Okay? 30, 30. So Amrusha, you can just listen and try to repeat. 60, 60. 21, 21. 46, 46. 59, 59, 16, 16, 40, 40, 50, 50, 31, 31, 70, 70, 49, 49, 13, 13. Très bien. Numéro 2. Écris le nombre qui manque. Please write down the number that is missing. Manque is something is missing. Manque is a missing thing. So, par exemple, numéro 1 is 26, 27, then comes 28, 29. Okay, numéro 2. 61, 63, 64. Qu'est-ce qui manque? What is missing? 62. Okay, numéro 3. 42, 43. Et bien 45. Qu'est-ce qui manque? 44. 13, 15, 16, 17. 14. 49, 51, 52. 50. 32, 33, 34. 35. Remember, you must practice the numbers. Bon. Now, numéro 3, complète les listes. Okay. They say 10, 8, 6, 4. So they're counting down in missing 2, skipping 2. 10, 8, 6, 4. So see if you can get the second one. 4, 8, 12, 16 in fours. Okay. 5, 10, 20. in 5, so it counts. If you don't get with me, then you must go and practice your numbers. 10, 20, 40. In 10, so it's 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay? 15, 18, 22, 33, 44. Now write it down. 22 is 22, 33 is 33, 44 is 44. So what will be the next one? 55. Okay? 70, 50, 40. So we're counting back in 10. 70 is 70, then it's 60, 50, 40. Now, 21, 41, 51. So 21, 41, 51. What would be the second one? 31. Très bien. Last one, derrière. 65, 60, 55. We're counting back in fives. If I'm too quick, please just pause the video. 65, 60, 55, 50. Bon, et le dernier exercice, the last exercise of this lesson. And Amrusha, if you now turn back your page, à la page 27, at the bottom, it's the same exercise. And we, ours is the bottom of page 26. They say ma maison. So listen, you are going to, you don't have tests anymore or exams for this year, but you are going to have a task about your house and your room. So just start thinking about it. Something like this. They say, écris une description de ta maison et de ton appartement avec une photo ou un dessin. So I would like a photo or a drawing and then what it is. Now, listen to this one and try to fill it in. J'habite 65 Guesswork Street. Dans ma maison, il y a... Now you can say how many. Say 8 pièces, 8 rooms. Le salon, how many bedrooms? 3 chambres. La cuisine, et maybe le salon. You can also say la salle à manger. Then you can describe. Dans la chambre de mes parents, il y a. Dans la chambre de mon frère, il y a. Dans ma chambre de ma soeur, il y a. I'll explain very nicely to you what I wanted. Don't do it now. Not yet. Il y a un lit, et une table, et une télévision, et un téléphone. Il y a une télévision. Where are your television? Dans le salon, dans la chambre, wherever. And then mon ordinateur est dans le bureau, maybe in the study, dans ma chambre. So that's more or less the way that you're going to describe your house, but I'll set it out very, very clearly for you. Ça va? So now, nous avons fini leçon 3. So now, we're done with leçon 3. So for our next lesson. Now remember, you have to do that now for the next lesson. YouTube lesson, that is now, in other words, for the week just before the holidays. So this lesson, what I did now that we missed, is for the week, for this week. And the lesson, next week's lesson is now for the week before the holidays, and then we'll go on. This is just a revision exercise.